I've been living like this for 5 years.
Everyone said if you hit the road and repeat the classics, you become someone. But I did that. Nothing changed. How do I break out of this?
Man, look at all these legends. What would Tommy do? Of course, he climbs big walls.
If I want to be a big wall hero, I've got to go huge. The Great Wall of China, the longest continuous rock climb in the world, 9,000 feet, 67 pitches, has never seen a continuous ascent? I've got to call Ben.
Oh, Drew?
Dude, I just found the longest route in the world. We have to go.
I don't know, man.
Dude, come on. We'll be totally fine.
Okay. I mean, do we have to leave right now?
I just bought last minute tickets, and I'll come over to your place in like, what, half hour?
Yeah, totally. I'll be ready. Oh. Yo, Ben.
Yeah, just grab your climbing gear. Let's do this.
All right. Oh, can't believe I let Drew talk me into this.
With Ben as my partner for this route, we've really got a shot. He's always got my back when others say it's too sketchy.
Come on, go get him. Let's go.
We're at the Portal Edge camp.
We've done some crazy trips in the past, but nothing like this.
Yeah, saddle up, buddy.
Dude, I have a feeling this is gonna be sick.
We rolled up in New Paltz with no information on the route. We had to ask around and get the insider information.
Have you climbed the Great Wall of China? Dude, let's go!
Other than our green mask homie, who claimed to have built the wall himself, info on this route was hard to come by. We decided it was time to pay a visit to the mecca of Gunks climbing, rock and snow.
We're gonna be doing our first Gunks route tomorrow. It's gonna be the Great Wall of China, and we just wanna get a little info.
Wait, Great Wall of China? Nobody does that route.
It's a 9,000 foot traverse from the left end to the right end of the main traps face, and it crisscrosses every other route in the Gunks. It's traverse, 67 pitches. You're never more than 60 feet off the ground.
Ken Nichols did the first ascent. They went left to right to just have that vision, to look at the traps and say, there's a route that goes across that. It's pretty epic.
We've never been to the Gunks. What's like?
What are we expecting?
You guys have never been here, and you're gonna climb the Great Wall of China?
Is it chossy at all, or?
I've never pulled a rock up a route, ever.
Really?
Rock here is real solid.
Like everyone says that the rock quality is really good, but it's totally not.
How many beers do you recommend we bring for a route like this?
Two beers per pitch, per person.
Yeah.
Ah, dude, I see you got started already.
We could probably do that.
Once you're up there and you're committed, I don't know how we would get you down. We don't have a helicopter. We don't have a 9,000 foot rope.
How many wag bags should we bring and how many poops can we expect to get in these things?
Three?
That's two poops.
Make sure you take enough gear, especially hexes, so they warn every climber that you're coming.
Do have hexes.
So yeah, you should be fine.
Yeah.
I feel pretty good, I think.
Yeah, that was super helpful.
I think
helpful.
We got it.
Can we just get that one wag bag?
Oh, yeah,
we'll give you a shout out when we do it.
Thanks, boss.
Thanks.
Word. We appreciate you guys.
Yo, what the f*** is wrong with those guys?
Those boys are gonna get hurt.
Those weirdos.
Having unearthed valuable beta from the gurus at Rock and Snow, it was time to make our way to the longest climb in the world, the Great Wall of China.
We cannot get a ride out here, so we've converted to skateboarding.
this is the wall.
Dude, look what I brought.
All right, it's game time. Let's gear up.
Top of the first pitch, built my anchor. I think we're moving pretty fast. That took like 15 minutes. Drew's down there getting set up. I think we got this.
To even attempt such a big route, we had to bring a ton of gear in proper big wall style.
What did you put in here, man?
Dude, we got 500 beers. You heard that guy.
I don't know, man. It's getting kind of dark though. I think we should set up the ledge.
Getting tossed around. This Gunks 5-4 is serious.
I don't ever want to haul like that again. I think we just got to get rid of it all.
Cut the bag. Give it all we've got.
Ben, don't touch this next block.
This block.
That thing's totally detached.
I think it looks pretty attached to me.
We opted to simul-climb, skipping belays and running it out to climb in huge chunks. It was risky, but it might be the only way we could finish off this climb.
Ben placed one piece at the top and then nothing. He still hasn't placed anything.
But we almost have a piece of pro up here, and I'll show you what it looks like.
It's actually that. It's that little tiny bush.
That's all you're gonna get. Drew, look at how well I protected you. Look at how much I care.
This is so nice.
I'm basically on top rope.
As long as you place at least three pieces of pitch, I'm cool.
I wasn't going to, but I can.
Back in the day, the guidebook authors would grade things not based on what the person said that it was, but on how hard they thought that person could climb.
We made it to pitch 9 in no time. We knew this is where it got real.
Yeah, Ben, come on.
I envision this being so much higher off the ground, you know?
Yeah. Nice, dude, yeah.
No matter what I place, you're gonna deck.
Yes, chill. Fourth day. Yes,
chill. Yeah.
Fuck yeah. Gotta love 5-9.
Dude, I'm like pumped.
You can't possibly carry enough gear to protect the traverses, so you're gonna be in groundfall territory the whole time.
Oh. Ah! Oh, dude. Good thing I placed two pieces this time.
Oh, dude.
Pendulum factor's looking pretty good right here.
Usually, it's nice to be the follower for some of the spicy pitches, but on a traverse like this, both ends are sharp.
Cool.
The loop of rope in front of me started zipping through the gear as Ben disappeared.
No! Fuck!
Oh, God. Snapped a hold off.
Good thing it's, like, just ledgy and I just hit the next ledge.
Dude, no way. Dude, where are we?
I don't know.
Lost as hell.
Climbed more than 3,000 feet now, and I'm worked.
Drew's just like en route on a crimp, puts his fingers in his mouth, pulls them open because they're cramped closed, and then hits the next crimp.
Here we are, approaching pitch 29. This is what we call the bush pitch.
Oh, dude, I'm catching on everything.
This route was harder than I'd imagined. Tough climbing, rotten rock. Everything was slowing us down.
We landed on a big ledge around pitch 30 and decided to call it a day.
What I like about this route is there's no rules. You get to an anchor and all you can place is one piece, like, sweet, that's good.
More pieces than I was expecting, you know?
I almost always had one piece between us.
Yeah.
Almost always.
We've been on the wall for just about 24 hours.
Today's breakfast is looking like we got broccoli, cheese, and bacon. We got some jazzy jambalaya.
Yeah. Oh God, it's so big.
Have you seen my pants?
Put your pants on.
Let's pull the guidebook out.
You know, 8-page description of the route. What else do we have to look forward to? Ooh. There's about 7 more lichen-covered faces, which I'm sure is like a very low-ball number.
There's so many mang pins up here, I'm gonna clip all of them for you, Ben.
I'm just questing, dude.
It's bomber this time for sure.
Like, just be aware that almost every section is gonna have tons of loose rock, lots of lichen.
Ben, how's it looking over there, man?
Drew, this next pitch looks downright filthy disgusting. We're about to dive right in.
This is so gnarly.
Oh, You're on belay, bud.
Soon we approached high exposure, most popular 5.6 in the whole United States. We knew it was a milestone, but we also knew it would be teeming with climbers. And if we could squirm our way through the other parties, we'd be well on our way.
I'll try to step out of your way here, man, sorry.
As we approached the yellow wall, we hadn't climbed as far as we'd liked, and we still had 20 pitches to go.
We needed to increase our pace and space our gear, but doing so came with more risk. The holds got smaller, and the feet seemed to fall away. I prayed Ben had placed a piece between us.
Just hear Drew around the corner. Well, I better place a piece or he's gonna take both of us off.
Somehow, I held on. With no pieces in sight, a close call. After almost becoming an upstate New York pancake, it was my lead.
Oh, bummer.
We didn't have enough soup or beer to make it another night, and we knew we had to push on.
After 35 hours on the wall, we could see the end.
We finally made it to the down climb that marked the end of the route.
At 69 total pitches, our feet finally touched down on upstate New York topsoil.
Longest route in the world. I bet the president's in town.
And all the papers. I bet everyone's gonna be waiting for us at Rock and Snow. Okay, I've been working like 3 jobs. Probably why I never see ya. Probably why I never have time for the fake friends I won't be ya. Oh God, I've been running now. Up early when the sun's out. Not setting out my own soul, but those real ones, they coming out. Oh look who's reaching out. Old friends wanna feature now. They don't work, so they need it free. Ooh, you reaching out from the west side of that old town. But there's no show, so I go down to the open mic. Show love to the real ones that know now. Some of y'all don't know now. In a couple months, you gon' find out. Been blowing up from the underground, and they stepping on a landmine now. And they know it's my time now. Coming up, I'm on a climb now. Everybody claim they been balling, but it's looking like they took a time out. Okay. I kind of figured it would be either really chill or really f***ed up. It's both of those things.
Go tight, man.
Put him in a portal edge till he's sober. Put him in a portal edge till he's sober. Put him in a portal edge till he's sober. Early in the morning.
I've heard that that Alex hot dog guy goes pretty fast. I'm going to recommend it to him.
Send him down the route for another 9,000. Send him down the route for another 9,000. Send him down the route for another 9,000. Early in the morning.